Hello and welcome to the program. My name is Vernon Howl. I'm the host of this show on the internet, www.coms, and this is the second episode of my show. It's my daily weekday talk show called the Vernon Howl Driving Back From Home, the Driving Home From Work Show, the Drive Time Show. And, it's good to be back. I had a nice little weekend. spent my weekend up in upstate New York. I went to a wedding, weird little town called Hudson, which, believe it or not, is on the Hudson. And, you know, anytime, you know, as I get older, these weekends, they take a lot more out of you, and then you get back to work on Monday and back to the old daily grind. I actually just went to my gym after work. It's about 6:24 Eastern Standard. In the PM on this, a Monday, this is the 21st day of May, 2012, something like the 11,000th day of my life. I don't have any guests lined up per se on the, drive-through, time show today, episode 2 Monday. I'm trying to line up some guests for future episodes. Traffic, like I said, a little bit later than I normally go home, because I stop by at the gym, which is right by my office, and it's a little later going home. But that the good thing about that is there's even less traffic. So the last time I did the show, it took 12 minutes to get home, which was unusually long, because there was some weird traffic on my road here to get home. But this is going to be a lot shorter because it's smooth sailing. So, good and bad of that is I don't have as much to talk about. I have stuff to talk about, but I won't have, it's not quite, you know, I don't have as much probably that I would have had if I had more time. But I don't have any guests. It would be really nice to get some guests, and sometimes when there is traffic, the traffic gets lined up going both ways, and I'm thinking about maybe, you know, if you pull up, maybe I pull up next to someone who looks like they're an interesting person, or a gal or a guy, in another car adjacent to me coming the other way, and maybe I give him the old roll down the window sign, and he gives me the old roll down the window sign, and We just get to strike up a conversation, and I'll just say, "Hey, Mister, don't know your name. What's your name? Would you like to be on a internet talk show that I tape in my car?" And I'm sure some people will be, they won't know what to think about that, but some people might want to talk, and then we can have they can be the guests on the show. Working on a few projects. As you may know, as a listener of the program, I am a very, very prolific artist and songwriter, one of the most prolific artists and songwriter in the country, in the world of all time. I'm not trying to brag by saying that or toot my own horn, so to speak, but just stating the obvious facts of My claim to fame, as some people have said, is I'm the most prolific songwriter. So I've written the most. By that I mean I have not written by any stretch of the imagination the best, or the best quality wise, but just that I've written the most songs of all time, and that's speculative. I am extrapolating my working schedule out until, let's say, I live to, at the very least, 55 years old. So if I can hang on until 55, it shouldn't really be close. I should be the most prolific songwriter of all time in the history of humankind. So that is you know, it's kind of my calling card. It's kind of how I, you know, introduce myself at parties. What do you do? I'm the most, blah, 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 you know, so. That being said, I have a new project that I'm kind of right in the middle of. Well, I'm not in the middle of it, but I'm right, you know, I've been immersed in it for about a week now. And it's called Pistons. It's going to be a 10 CD set, album set. Every CD will have 99 tracks, because that is the most amount of tracks that any CD can have. So they'll each be about, I'm hoping they're going to be about 40 and 50 minutes long. And what the CDs, or this collection of CDs, is going to be about, really, is I've been recording every pee I take. So it's only my pees. So if I do a poop and I also pee, I don't record that. I just record the times I'm standing and urinating. Nothing else. So no other pees or no other bodily functions get recorded. And so far, I'm up to 40, in the 40s, after a couple days. Like I said, this weekend, partied a little hard, so I was very much dehydrated today. And I forgot, I usually bring water to work, I didn't actually have any liquid today until lunch. And at which case I did a kind of number one, number two combo. So actually, I've only peed one time today, if you could believe that. I have to pee again, so I'm going to go record another pee soon enough. But, so that's just the one pee today, which is, I think, the 42nd pee since I started doing this. So this album's going to be called Pisses, 5/16/12, the date, 2, and then I don't know when it's going to end, because I can't quite figure out. You know, once I get the first date, first 99 tracks, so to speak, and yeah, I do, you know, you're asking yourself, oh, well, if you're going to count these 990 songs to your total amount of songs ever written, that's kind of cheap, but you know, I'm a conceptual artist, and I have declared that I'm calling these songs, and I am counting these into my repertoire, of which many are actual songs, albeit many short ones, but the vast majority of my catalog is not, you know, just recordings, iPhone recordings of people peeing, or me peeing. You know, most of them are song-type songs, with melodies and chord progressions, albeit there's a lot, there's a couple thousand probably that are very under a minute long, but they would be more, you know, more what you would normally consider a song, as opposed to a 23-second clip MP3 of, the sound of someone urinating, which is good and going, but this project can be 10 CDs, and it's probably going to be about $40 for sale, and there might be like, I might have a deluxe package, maybe like $80 that's going to come with, I want to get, I don't know the legalities of doing this, but if I could get some sort of a, well, like a, not like a lot, like a, there's a word for what this is, but I can't think of it right now. It's the little glass things you put on a necklace that hold liquid. Not locket, not charms. Something. I think there's an actual term for a glass thing that holds some liquid that you put in a necklace, and so it's like a medieval term, I think, or something. It's a lodge, something like that. So maybe I'll sell this like an $80 deluxe version of this 10 CD set, which will come with a locket full of. You can guess what it would be full of, which would be my urine, and. Again, legalities of doing something like that are, I have to look into it a little more before I actually go ahead with that. But, we're at least, well, let's see here, 4, 5, 8, that's at least 2-3 months down the road, but that's one of the projects I'm working on now, and as I say that, we're pulling into the old house, and we pull into the house, so you end the program, because the show is over, because I'm home and no longer driving, hence the drive time show comes to an end. But we'll see you tomorrow. I got my daily talk show on the internet, Vernon Howl's Drive Time. Thanks for listening or watching on YouTube, but you're just listening. Okay, thank you.